ఇంటర్మీడియట్ విద్యా రంగంలో అగ్రగామి మన ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్ ఎడ్యుకేషన్ ఇన్స్టిట్యూషన్ ఐఐటి జేఈఈ అయినా నీట్ అయినా తిరుగులేని విద్యా సంస్థ ఎన్ఎస్ఆర్ ఇంపల్స్.
సో నెక్స్ట్ సో ఇన్ కేస్ ఆఫ్ రెసిస్టెన్సెస్ ఇఫ్ యూ డూ ఎనీ నంబర్ ఆఫ్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ సో దట్స్ మెయిన్ వే ఈస్ విచ్ టైప్ what are the resistances are in series and what are the resistances are in parallel, that is important. That's the thing we have to know by observing the this circuit, given circuit, and what are the resistances are in series and what are the resistances are in parallel. That's we have to understand by observing the circuit, and it is easy way. How much fast you are solving, series or parallel? If they are in series, plus 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 plus. If they are in parallel, effective R by N. If they are, if all those are equal resistances, then R by N, like that. R 1 by R equals to 1 by R 1 plus 1 by R. That's how much fast you can do, that much fast is. So next one more problem, let us say like this. So this is the condition. Let us say it is a point A, it is a point B. Effective resistance between point, let us say all are same, 2 2 2 2 2 2, like this. How can you find out the effective resistance between A and B? So here current is I. Current divides in three ways. So total amount of current passing towards the junction is equals to total current passing away from the junction. So now 2 and 2 are in. Here the current passes like this, same amount of current passing in this line. So here there is no junction, that's why there is no division of current here. See here, this current passes through the circuit and reaches to this position. There is no division of the current there. There is no division of the current. So here 2 and 2 are in series. First 2 comma 2 are in series. So therefore 2 plus 2, 4 ohms. Now the circuit becomes this is 4, 2, 2, 2, 2, because 2 plus 2, 4. Here the current divides, this is one current and this is another current, this is another current. That means this one and this one must be parallel. Where the current divides, those must be are in parallel situation, parallel combination. Those are in parallel combination. So here current divides here. So this one and this one and this one are in parallel. So this one and this one and this one are in, three are parallel. So here the current one, and it divides into three branches. So these three are in parallel. So first 2 comma 2 are in series, so that is 4. Here 4 and 2 are in parallel. 4 comma 2 are in parallel, so that is 4 into 2 by 4 plus 2, so 8 by 6. 8 by 6 means 4 by 3. If two resistances are in parallel, effective resistance R1, R2 by R1 plus R2. So that is 4 into 2 by 4 plus 2, that is 8 by 6, that is 4 by 3. Now, here the condition is, instead of this total, how much we got? 4 by 3. like this. This is A and this is B. So step by step we are calculating, so first 2 comma 2 are in series, so this is the possible diagram. 4 and 2 are in parallel, how much we got? 4/3. So this is 4/3. Now here at this position current divides, this current travels like this and reaches to this position. That means this one and this one are in series. There is no division of current here, because there is no coming of current, there is no leaving of current. So here this is the current passes like this and reaches to this position. So that's why same amount of current passes through here, same amount of current passes through 4 by 3 and 2. That means 4 by 3 and 2 are in series. So effective is 4 by 3 plus 2. How much? 10/3. So here now the situation is, so 2 2, so 10/3. So that is the condition. 4/3, 2 are in series. 4/3 and 2 are in series, therefore total is 10/3, because these two are in series. Effective R1 plus R2, that is 10/3. So this is the next possible diagram. 2 2 and 10 by 3. Next, 10/3 and 2 are in parallel again. 10/3 and 2 are in parallel, therefore R effective is 10/3 into 2 by 10/3 plus 2. If two resistances are in parallel, effective resistance R1 R2 by R1 plus R2. So 20/3 divided by 16/3. 20/16, 5/4. 3 gets cancelled, 20/16, that is 5/4. So instead of these two, it is 5/4. So now the resistance is, the condition is, this is A and this is B. This is 2 and this is 5/4. This is 2 and 5/4. So here 2 comma 5/4 are series, because here the same amount of current passing. There is no division of current here. There is no division of current. So therefore 2 plus 5/4, 8 plus 5, that is 13/4. That is the effective resistance. And this is a way to solve this type of circuit. Of course, it takes this much time, but how much fast you can do? So this matter of 30 seconds. So 2 2 series, series parallel, series parallel, series. 2 2 series, 4. 4 2 parallel, 4/3. 4/3 2. Series 4/3 and 2 series, 10/3. 10/3 2 parallel, 5/4. 5/4 2 series, 13/4. So how much fast we can analyze the, this circuit, that much fast we can do that problem. So that is, this is the way to do the problem. So division of current, where the current divides at the junction, definitely the current divides, that is parallel combination. So next, so okay, these are the small circuits, simple circuits we can do based on series and parallel combination, okay, no problem. But in case of big networks, number of resistances are in series or parallel. So for example, see here, not like this. For example, like this. like this. How can we calculate the effective resistance this type of circuits? How can we calculate this effective resistance in this situation? So somewhat complicated. How can you do very easily? How can we do very easily within the span of 40 to 50 seconds? Within the span of 30 to 40 seconds, how can we calculate this? So here the current divides three ways, and again current divides, and again same current, and here so current meets. What are the series combination? What are the parallel combination? What resistances are in series and what resistances are in parallel? So much confusion here. So much confusion. Then how can you calculate this time? See here, that is based on symmetry rule. Symmetry rule. So two types of symmetry we have. Symmetry. So in that first we can discuss about mirror symmetry. Mirror symmetry. What is mirror symmetry? So you see here, first we are discussing about simple thing. So it's a point A and it's a point B. How can we calculate the effective resistance between A and B? So let us say it is 2R and it is 2R and it is R and it is R and it is also R. How can we calculate the effective resistance between A and B? So this is the current here. The current divides. So let us say it is I1 and it is I2. So it is I1, it is I2. Mirror symmetry means, see here, mirror symmetry means, here let us say I am considering this line, this acts as the mirror. Mirror symmetry in the sense, so here I am considering this is acts as a mirror, this line acts as a mirror. Mirror in the sense, what are the, what is the object in this, same here we have to observe. For example, here I am standing here in the mirror only. What is the visible image in the mirror? Mine only. There is no other image. So in the same way, see here, so this is the first, this is A and this is B. Let us say it is positive terminal and it is negative terminal. Current flows from positive terminal to negative terminal, no doubt about that. Current passing from positive terminal to negative terminal. See here, this is A and this is B. See here, I divides I1 and I2, and it is 2R, it is 2R, this is R and this is R. So here I am considering one line that fold, let us say this is one, this acts as a mirror. So whatever is the objects here, same objects must be appear here. For example, I am standing here in the mirror. What can be observed? My image. So it is 2R. What is here? 2R. What is R? Here also it is R. What is I1? Current. Same amount of current passes. And it is I2. Same amount of current passes. In case of mirror symmetry, in case of mirror symmetry, what are the resistance in the left hand side, same amount of resistances exist, must exist in the right hand side, then only we can apply this mirror symmetry condition. Then only we can apply this mirror symmetry condition. In this mirror symmetry condition, whatever is the current here, same amount of current also must flows here. And whatever is the current here, same amount of current must exist here. That's very important. So here this is 2R and this is also 2R, and this is R, this is also resistance R. So this is one side and this is other side of the mirror, let us say other side of the mirror. Whatever is the resistance here, same amount of resistances here, then only it is possible to apply mirror symmetry. So in that situation, whatever is the current here, same amount of current must exist. Whatever is the current here, same amount of current must exist. Same amount of current must exist. So that's very, very, very important here. So now, if the same amount of current passes here, there is no division of current. There is no division of current here. So that means this resistance doesn't have any meaning because whatever is the current here, same amount of current flows here, because this is resistance R, this is also, sorry, here it is 2R and here also it is 2R. Mirror symmetry, in case of mirror symmetry, there is no division of current here, that's why this resistance doesn't have any meaning. So that's why, and final it is, final this is A and this is B, this is 2R, this 2R, it's R and it's R, 2R, 2R series, 4R, 2R. So now this is 4R and this is 2R and this is A and it is B. 4R and 2R are in parallel. So 4R into 2R divided by 4R plus 2R. So 8R square by 6R. So 4 by 3R. Simple technique. Simple technique. So this is 2R and here also it is 2R. It is R and it is also R. So that means same amount of resistance must be reflected. So that means same amount of resistance must be existed on the other side also. Then it is possible to apply mirror symmetry. If it is a mirror symmetry, if it is the current, same amount of current passes. If it is the current, same amount of current passes. So there is no meaning of this middle resistance. And this is dummy resistance, invalid resistance. Then the circuit becomes like this. So this is effective resistance is 4 by 3R. Effective resistance is 4 by 3R. That is important. So this is called mirror symmetry. This is called mirror symmetry. In case of mirror symmetry, left side and right side must exist same type of resistances, same resistances. Then only we can apply this mirror symmetry. So let us do one example based on this. So this is the circuit. So this is a point A, it's a point B. How can you find out the effective resistance between A and B? All are resistances, equal resistances. All are equal resistances here. Now, how can we calculate the effective resistance between A and B here? So let us say, so A and it's B, this is positive terminal and this is negative terminal. Current passes here, here the current divides and again here the current divides. Let us say it is I1 and it is I2, it is I2, it's I3, it is I4, like that. So how can you calculate the effective resistance between A and B? We don't know what are the series combinations and what are the parallel combinations. What is series and what is parallel? We don't know. So in these situations, we can apply mirror symmetry. So let us say, here is the mirror. Just I am considering the mirror like this. And one more thing, remember that mirror symmetry does not apply like this between the terminals A and B, does not apply between the terminals A and B. That is very, very important. The mirror symmetry must be, so symmetry line must be considered perpendicular to the line joining the effective resistances. That's very, very important. So always we must consider this is normally. So this is A and this is B. Here it is resistance R, here also resistance R. Here it is resistance R, here also resistance R. It is R and it is R. Here R. So say whatever are the resistances exist in the left side, same amount of resistances existing in the right side also. So now it is possible to apply mirror symmetry. Here. That is the main reason here. So whatever are the resistances in the left side, same amount of resistances exist in the right side. So this is the situation. Now, in this situation, see here, so this is I1. So the, in case of mirror symmetry, same amount of current passes, I1 only, and it is I3, same amount of current passing here. This is I3 and it is I3, whatever is the current here, same amount of current must passes. Here also the same amount of current passes. So that is important. In case of mirror symmetry, whatever is the current in the left side, same amount of current in the right also. Here it is I1, same amount of current. Here it is I2, here also, So that means here I3, I4 divides. I4 travels like this. And it is I3 and I4 combined I2. Don't get confused. Mirror symmetry. So if you draw the big diagram here. So like this. This is the diagram and this is the point A positive terminal and this is the point B negative terminal. Now we can calculate the effective resistance between A and B. This is the current I, it divides. Let us say I1 and it is I2. So now I am applying mirror symmetry here. So same amount of resistances R like that. So whatever are the resistance in the left side, same amount of resistances exist in the right side also. So therefore, there is no change. So that's why we can apply mirror symmetry. So this is I1 means here also I1. Whatever is the current here, same amount of current exists in the mirror also. So if I am standing here in the mirror, what we can observe? My image only. There is no other image. So that is, whatever is the current I1, here also the current is I1. Here it is I2 and it is also I2. And here the also current divides. Same amount of current passes. So let us say it is I4. Here the same amount of current passes. So now, here this is the junction. Here I1 and I3 combine, so not possible. So here I1 same amount of current passes and I3 also same amount of current passes. Now the circuit becomes, see here, So there is no connection here, because if it is the junction, the current must be I1 passing towards the junction, I3 passing towards the junction. If these two combined and same amount of current passing, that's why. So there is no connection here. That means if you remove this connection, this is the fake connection, here it is. That's why like this. So this is A and this is B and this is R. Then we can easily calculate. R and R are in series, and this R and R are in series. Now the circuit becomes, now R in series, 2R, this is also 2R, 2R, 2R in parallel. Listen carefully, this is here it is, same amount of current passes through these lines, same amount of current passing, here also the same amount of current passing, that's why there is no meaning of this connection, there is no meaning of connection, that's why we can remove that connection. So that is the simplification of this mirror symmetry. To remove this type of only, we can using this type of mirror symmetry without complicating. Don't complicate this problem here. So that's why we are removing this connection. So this becomes, this is R2R and this is R2R. So 2R2R in parallel. Then 2R2R in parallel means, if two resistances are in parallel, 2R plus 2R. So 4R square by 4R, that is equals to R again. So now the situation is like that. So R. So point A, so point B, so R. That is the diagram becomes. So this is R2R series, because same amount of current passes, and here also the same amount of current passes, R and R are 2R. Here R and R 2R, 2R 2R in parallel, here the current divides, that's why 2R 2R parallel. If 2R 2R parallel, effective resistance is R. For this total combination, the effective resistance is R. So the remaining circuit is like this, R, this R. So simplified the circuit is. So if the current passes like this, R series, R plus R, how much? 3R, R plus R, that is 3R. So 3R and this is R plus R, 2R. So 3R and 2R are in parallel. R 3R and 2R are in parallel. So that is effective resistance between A and B, 3R into 2R divided by 3R plus 2R. So 6R square divided by 5R, that is 6 by 5R. So that is the effective resistance between A and B in this situation. Simple way to do this circuit. So this is the mirror symmetry. Without using mirror symmetry, so first, what are the two resistances? Here the current divides, these two parallel. Again, here the current divides, these two parallel. These two parallel, these two parallel. How can we calculate? So again here, so that's somewhat complicated. That way, we are using this mirror symmetry, same resistance in the left side and same resistance in the right side. Same resistance. So that's why, due to mirror symmetry, same amount of current passes through the branches. Here it is I1, here it is I2 and it is I2, this is I3. So same amount of current passes like this, that's why we are removing this connection here. So that is the situation. Now R2R parallel, effective is R. So the circuit becomes R. These three are series, because same amount of current passes, R series, 3R. Next, R and R, 2R. So 3R and 2R are parallel. So effective resistance is 6 by 5R. Effective resistance is 6 by 5R. That is the way to calculate the effective resistance in mirror symmetry method. Mirror symmetry method. Next. Next, one more problem we can do based on this. Let us say this is the situation, this is the point A and it is the point B. So here the current I. If you remove this, later we can do this. So this is the situation. So how can you calculate the effective resistance between A and B? Effective resistance between A and B. Of course, here also we can take resistances, no problem. That is the situation. So here the current divides into three branches. Let us say I1, it is I2, it is I3. Current divides like this. So current divides like this. How can we calculate the situations right now? Here I am applying the mirror symmetry like this. So same, all are same resistances, all are same resistances, equal resistances. So if you apply the mirror symmetry here, what is I3 here? The same amount of I3 here, the same amount of I1 here, next same amount of I2 here. Here the I3 passing here, this left side and right side must have the same conditions. That is the mirror symmetry condition. So this is I1, here also it is I1. This is I3, here also it is I3. It is I2 and here also it is I2. Here I1 divides. So I1 divides here. Whatever is the current here, same amount of current here, and here also it is divides. Whatever is the current here and same amount of current passes here. So that is the situation here. This is I1, I2, I3. So same amount of current here I1, same amount of current here I3, same amount of current here I2. And here also current divides. This is the junction. Current divides. Whatever is the current passes here, same amount of current passes here because mirror. So left hand side and right hand side must have the same conditions. This is current and this is also the same current. Here also it is the current and here also it must be the same current. It must be the same current here. So now the conditions becomes how the circuit will be See here, this is the same current passes. This junction must be fake. No need to connect, no need to continue that junction. We can break that junction. We can break that junction. So based on this, now the circuit becomes so if you remove that junction, the circuit becomes so like this. This is the situation. R like this. So this is the point A and this is the point B. Now the situation is here the current passes like this, same amount of current passes these two, this R and R, this R and R are in series. R in series, 2R. This R and R are in series, 2R and R are in parallel. R comma R are in series. So that is equals to R plus R, 2R. Then 2R and R are in parallel. So therefore 2R into R divided by 2R plus R. 2R square by 3R, that is 2 by 3R. 2R square by 2R by 3. See here, I am calculating this only for this network. This R and R are in series because same amount of current passes. 2R and R are in series means 2R. 2R and R are in parallel, that is 2R by 3. So here also the must be same. R and R are in series, 2R. And it is 2R and R are in parallel, that is 2R by 3. Now, the circuit becomes here. Like this. So, this is R and this is 2R by 3. And this is R, 2R by 3, R. So, instead of this one, this R and R and R, 2R by 3 we get. Because this R, R series 2R, 2R and R are in parallel, that is 2R by 3. So, this total is 2R by 3 and here also this total is 2R by 3. Remaining all are same. R, 2R by 3, R, R, 2R by 3, R. So here R 2R by R plus 2R by 3 plus R. So that is 3 LCM, 3R plus 2R plus 3R. So 8R by 3. 8R by 3. So this is R. Sorry, this is also small only. 2R by 3. R 2R by 3 R are in series. Effective is 8R by 3. So now the situation is this A, B. This is 8R by 3. So this is 2R. R and R are in series. And it is 8R by 3. R, 2R by 3, R are in series. 8R by 3. 8R by 3, 2R, 8R by 3 are in parallel. 8R by 3, 2R and 8R by 3 are in parallel. So therefore, 1 by R effective is equals to 1 by 8R by 3 plus 1 by 2R plus 1 by 8R by 3. So 3 by 8R plus 1 by 2R plus 3 by 8R. Sorry, small. 8R is the LCM. 3 plus 4 plus 3. So 10 by 8R. 10 by 8 R. So 1 by R effective is equals to 10 by 8 R. R effective is equals to 8 R by 10, that is 4 by 5 R. So effective resistance between A and B in this total circuit is 4 by 5 R. So that is the mirror symmetry situation it is. So first we are calculating this current divides here. Here I am considering the mirror, so that is symmetry line. So whatever are the resistance in the left side, same amount of resistance must exist in the right side also. So whatever is the current here, same current. Here also in this branch, same amount of current must flows. If the same amount of current must flows, here the junction must be break. So that's why the resultant circuit is like this. Same amount of current passes here. In this line, same amount of current passes. That's why R and R are in series. That is 2R. Again, 2R and R are in parallel. So 2R and R are in parallel is 2R by 3. So replacement of this is 2R by 3. Replacement of this is 2R by 3. So 2R by 3, 2R by 3. Remaining circuit R, 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 R. Here R, 2R by 3 and R are in parallel, series. R, 2R by 3 are series. So series means effective is 8R by 3. So now 8R by 3, R and R are in series, 2R, again 8R by 3. All are in parallel, effective is, so 4 by 5 R. So effective resistance is 4 by 5 R. That is the situation here. This is a way to solve the problem. So if you are perfect in this, so it is the span of 40 seconds or 50 seconds maximum it is. So next we can discuss about folding symmetry. So previous we discussed about mirror symmetry, now we can discuss about folding symmetry. So in case of mirror symmetry, we are discussing about current, same amount of currents. Left side and right side, same amount of current existing. So mirror symmetry, left side of the mirror, right side of the mirror, whatever is the currents, same currents must be flows. But in case of folding symmetry, see here, simple network, it is A and it is B, simple network. It is R, it is 2R and it is 2R, it is R. See here, folding symmetry means, so in case of mirror symmetry, we considered the mirror perpendicular to the line joining the effective resistance. For example, if you want to find out the effective resistance A and B here, we consider the mirror symmetry perpendicular to that line. But in this situation, in case of folding symmetry, if we consider the symmetry line along the points where we have to find out the effective resistance between those two points, we have to consider the symmetry line. That is a major difference between mirror symmetry and folding symmetry. So mirror symmetry means symmetry line must be considered perpendicular to the line joining the effective resistance points. But in case of folding symmetry, the symmetry line must be drawn along the line joining the effective resistance points. Along the line joining the effective resistance points. See? So this is A and this is B. The line joining like this. This is a folding symmetry line. So in case of folding symmetry, see here. Again, if you draw this. So this is a point A, this is the line, and it's a point B. So here let us one potential x, and here also one potential x. Folding symmetry, whatever is the potential above that line, same amount of potential existing below the line. Whatever is the potential above the line, same amount of potential existing below the line. So previous mirror symmetry, we considered the currents, same amount of currents. But here we are considering same amount of potentials. Below and above same potential must exist across these resistances. So this is, let us say this is Y and it is also Y. Let us say it is Z and it is also Z. This is R, R. This is 2R and this is 2R. And one more condition is, between the potentials, between the same potentials, same resistances also must exist. Here it is xy and it is xy. X potential, y potential. X potential, y potential. Potentials are same. In the same way, resistances also must be same. Then only we can apply this folded symmetry. For example, if it is R, it is 4R. Not possible to apply the folding symmetry. Not possible to apply the folding. If it is R, if it is 4R, these potentials may be different. Here it is R and here also it is R. That's why same potential difference exists. It is 2R and it is 2R. That's why same potential difference exists. Otherwise, potential difference may not be same. So, resistances must be below and above same resistances exist. In the previous situation, left side and right side same potential, same currents exist. In the same way, same resistance also exists. In the same way, below and above the symmetry line, same potentials exist, same resistances must be exist. For example, if two resistances are between the same potential points, if two resistances between the same potential points, those two must be parallel. See here, this is AB, it is AB. These two resistances must be between same potential points. This is A and this is B. Same potential difference exists. That's why these two must be in parallel. So like that. Here, it is X and Y and it is also X and Y. So here also potential difference same and here also potential difference same. That's why R and R are in parallel. Just I am considering here the potentials. Here it is X, Y, X, Y, X, Y. The potential difference between the resistance is X, Y. Here also the potential difference between the resistance is X, Y. So that means this R and R must be in parallel. R and R are in parallel. That is R into R by R plus R, R square by 2R, that is R by 2. Effective resistance is R by 2. In the same way, here 2R existing between Y and Z, here also 2R existing between Y and Z. 2R existing between Y and Z, here also 2R existing between Y and Z. Again, 2R and 2R are parallel. That is 2R into 2R divided by 2R plus 2R, 4R square by 4R, that is R. This R and R are in parallel, effective resistance R by 2. This 2R and 2R are in parallel, effective resistance is R. And one more resistance here we have R. What about this one? Here one more resistance. So here what is the potential? Y. Here also the potential is Y. If the two potentials must be same, is there any current passes through that? Is there any current passes through that? No. zero current passes. If the current is zero, the resistance is negligible. See here, here the potential is y, here also the potential is y. Same potential difference exists. If the potential difference is same, no current passes through that. No current passes through that means, no current passes, that means this resistance is negligible. Now the circuit becomes, this is a point A, this is R by 2 and this is R, so point B, that's all. So folded symmetry means bottom line or bottom circuit or upper circuit must be minimized. Here this is R and R are in parallel, 2R and 2R are in parallel, R and R are in parallel, 2R and 2R are in parallel. If R and R are in parallel, R by 2, 2R and 2R are in parallel, R. So that means bottom circuit must be minimized. Instead of these two, R by 2. Instead of these two, it is R. And based on these two, effective resistances we got R by 2. By using these two, effective resistance is R. Therefore, R effective is equals to R by 2 plus R, that is equals to 3R by 2. That is 3R by 2. So that is the effective resistance. And this is a way to do the folding symmetry. Folding symmetry means this must be folded to top. Folded to top. That's all. Simple. So across each and every resistance we can consider certain potentials. Here resistance R. That means if you want to use this folded symmetry, bottom and above resistance must be same. So that's why here also I am considering potential X, Y. Across this resistance X and Y. So these two are in parallel. And here 2R, 2R are in parallel. And effective is series. So that is 3R by 2. This is way to do the folding symmetry.